Laravel 11 is now out and it's available for everybody to start using. You know, one of the chores when a new Laravel version comes out, and this is with basically any software package, you have to do the updates. And of course, they are a little bit of a manual process. It's, you know, not too bad, but the documentation will actually outline exactly what needs to happen and all the differences between Laravel 10 and Laravel 11. So you should always read through that to find, you know, what's required, what's going to be a breaking change, what's just going to be a minor change, and even things that change that might not affect you at all. But one of the good ways to update is to use one of the Laravel community services called Laravel Shift. You can purchase a shift for like $9, $10, and it creates a pull request and does everything for you. It's amazing. So in this video, I want to run through upgrading the Laravel News website from Laravel 10 to Laravel 11. So let's dive in, take a look. So here I am on the Laravel Shift website, and all you have to do is sign in with Git, and then click the Run Shift button. From here, you're going to scroll down and pick Laravel 11 and purchase. And as you can see right now, it's $9. And then from here, you're just going to enter your repository or clone URL and what branch you want to use. I've already ran this, so it's been taken care of. If I switch over to the the recent shifts, you can see the Laravel 11 shift ran on laravelnews.com 3 hours ago, and it created the pull request of number 5. So if I swap over to the repo, I can go to pull request, Laravel 11 shift. And as you can see, it gives you a little comment on what it's done. But then what's really nice is if you scroll down, it gives you comments on every single change it's made through your entire application. So you can see, you know, everything that it's done, everything that it's doing. It's pretty neat. And then if you go over to the the commits, everything is staged into different commits. So if you don't like the way something ran or there's an error in something, you can always, you know, back out that one commit or, you know, make changes that way. So the first one to look at is remove default app files. And here you can see it cleaned up all this for me. It removed the HTTP kernel, all the middlewares, the providers, you know, everything that basically Laravel 11 doesn't need anymore. It went ahead and removed those for me. Now let's switch over to the code editor and open up a Bootstrap app. And you can see it has shift itself has taken care of bringing everything over to the brand new Laravel 11 style. You can see it's already registering the providers. It pulled over the routing that I was using, in this case, web API and commands, kept the brand new health up route, registered any of the middlewares I have, and then also added the any exceptions that I have set up. So that is pretty sweet, and it's nice to basically have all that handled, you know, right there. The next thing is in the config directory. You can see it did keep config items, and basically it kept the ones that I had customized. You can see right here in app, I have an array item called optimize images, which basically is just a true false, and that determines whether I'm using the CDN, you know, in production or not, you know, for local testing and development. So it kept that, it kept all the things that I have customized, but then it moved to the new Laravel 11 style on everything else. So again, I mean, this is, you know, Laravel Shift is just a great way to update your apps because it's going to do everything, it's going to take care of everything. And you just, you know, kind of scroll through, make sure it didn't make any mistakes. In my case, it didn't, so it's, you know, it's good to go now. You know, make sure your tests still run, make sure all your composer packages work, make sure you can composer install just in case, you know, some packages might not be updated the day of the Laravel 11 release. So you might have to wait a few days for, you know, any required packages you use to come out with a Laravel 11 version. So those are some things to keep in mind of. But otherwise, I mean, definitely check out Laravel Shift. Like I said, huge time saver, and just takes care of everything for you. So thanks for watching and enjoy that Laravel 11 update.